So the next game coming up on pitch one, as we're about to hear from the announcer, is yeah, he's been my nemesis all time with the on-pitch announcer. But yes, this is Salmi of Finland versus the Netherlands. So we'll just run through those, the Dutch team and the Finnish team, as we get going into this tournament. Holland, of course, have been strong as a host nation. What's your opinion of them today?
They've looked very, very comfortable playing at home. Excellent so far in games, and they seem to have a real character in their goalkeeper Jasper. He's seems to be the life and soul of that squad, really.
Yeah, exactly.
He was on local Dutch television as well last Thursday, promoting the tournament, and he did a really good job, actually.
Also, I'd like to get a bit of feedback in here. I've not been putting my my Twitter handle out on this, but I think I might do now. If you want to tweet me at TD Crosby, or also just please tweet anything to the Homeless World Cup. But we've got a tweet in from Nina, who says, great effort by me, she thinks, on the Homeless World Cup commentary, getting wired in with gusto on the Peruvian names. Well, thank you very much, Nina. I'm trying my absolute best on these names, although I did, of course, call Peru Chile at least twice in that game, and then I might have called Chile Peru later on in the tournament as well. So we'll try and avoid that sort of Freudian slip as we go on, but thank you very much for getting in touch there, Nina. So this Dutch side has been strong all tournament. We've already seen them on pitch one earlier on today. We've got number 6, Mehdi Adelkish. Number 9, Zaharendini Dekau. Number 10, Sahif Fahan. Fahan's been a great player, as has number 7, David Gramsma. David Gramsma has been playing a lot of the game. Also, watch out for number 8, Damien Hall. Spelt Dutch, but a very English-sounding name. He's been theatrical in the extreme, even attempting some form of scissor kick at one point in the game earlier on. We've also got Jasper Lambeau in goal, and Lorenzo Samba. Samba, again, another strong player for this Dutch outfit. So we really see a lot from the Dutch today. Salmi, as they would be called by their own home nation, are the Finnish team. Have yet to really feature on commentary today, but we've got a Finnish team comprised of Lauri Immonen, Samuli Itkanonen. I'm going to do my best with this again. Forgive me, Finland. Your language is unlike many in Europe. I've got Pepe Lauoto, Keijo Lapas, Ino Nummenma, Juna Siren, again, another contender for my absolute top team collection of about 8 players that I want to get together with the best names at this tournament. I've got Hern Tionang and Vili Virtanen. So we'll get this game underway. This is Netherlands versus Holland, versus Finland. And this is closing up, getting close to some of the final games of today. The final game will be at 6:40 later. Holland in possession. Number nine, Derekau in the centre. It's a great effort already by Holland to take some early pressure and turn it into an early goal. That's brilliant by the Dutch side. We saw some absolutely excellent team goals by the Dutch early on. Some great shows of skill on the volley, especially in their first game today. Derekau in space. Slowly held though by the Finnish goalkeeper.
Good touch by the Dutchman there.
They're holding that ball well, and they've used that overlap as well. That's the number 11, Lorenzo Samba. Samba wants to watch Derekau in the centre. Excellent player. And we've got Bert. That's a great save by Lambu, would you say? He's absolutely rolled that ball up the Dutch Lion in goal there.
Absolutely, yeah. Another good save from Jasper.
I just need to be a bit more careful there. Some of these challenges have been quite hard in certain games. Derekau with a free kick. Come across to the centre, to Gramsma. Number 7, Gramsma, the goal scorer. Also the scorer of many goals for Holland in this tournament. Gramsma, really a competent player. Gramsma, Sambra on the right, number 11, and Derekau on that left wing. For Finland at the moment, because we've not really talked about their team much, and I do apologise to any fans listening in from Salmi, I've got the number 17, who is Virtanen. That's number 17, Vertanen. We've got number 19, who's Luoto, on the pitch there. And we'll just get you that final name. This is another great finish by Bransma. That's twice now. He's absolutely kicking those balls in from that wing. That left wing's been a very, very strong place for the Dutch throughout the tournament. To Holland. Excellent again, great close quarters play by Delacau. I assume I am putting that throat sound in the right place as well. We'll have to find out in camp later on tonight. Lambeau getting the ball away. Delacau back to Sambra. Acres of space for Bransma, and he's been a little bit flustered there by good finish goalkeeping, would you say?
Absolutely, yeah, it's good save low down to the right.
So how would you say Finland would get a handle on this game?
I think they maybe need to try and calm it down and get into the half, the Dutch half, and keep possession.
Yeah, because they've been winning these balls quite strongly at times. Yeah. Again, a bit of good theatrics by Delacau. I think what you really need to see is he's a close-quarters skill. Like we saw from the Irish, we're able to play the ball round people in that last game. What we've also seen from the Dutch is a bit of possession. I mean, I did go there and did mention total football earlier on, and it's difficult to say total football when you're three men on a pitch that rotate continuously anyway. However, the possession has been very, very impressive by the Dutch sides.
I think the technical level that the Dutch players have is very, very good.
Because of course they played their own tournament, their own Street Soccer tournament in this venue before this one began. It was like used as a sort of warm-up, is that correct?
Yeah, I think that's right. The Dutch Street Cup, the final I think was held on Friday of last week.
Exactly, so the Dutch have had a great pull to pull from, but you've really got to say that Finland need to get a handle on this game very, very soon. We've got Herve Tajonen, which is the number 20 for Holland. That's a great tackle by Tajonen. They really need to get hold of this ball, Finland. Get a bit of possession, get a bit of control. So a bad effort, that excellent, excellent covering defence by Sambra, because that, from the Finnish 15, should have been a goal. So Tunnel at the moment, can you see more goals for Netherlands in this half?
I think so, yeah. The Finnish need to maybe keep it simple and work their way upfield.
Exactly.
Just keep possession when they're in the Dutch half and they have the advantage.
And number 14, Samuliit Konen, has come on for Finland. Very recognisable with his bright silvery blonde hair. The number 19 there for Finland, which is Pepe Luoto. He's really worked himself into a bit of a fuss in that centre. Good pressure by the number 14. It's Muljeto Ken making his presence known really up front for Finland. Nice bit of skill by Delacau. Ball across, Gramsma, a lot of time for Gramsma, ultimately wasted there. Luoto in the corner, caught with Gramsma in a bit of a deadlock. Manages to clear it away though.
Good goal right there.
It was, wasn't it? Good run across by Sambra as well to get that back to Lambeau in the Dutch goal. Strong challenge by the Finnish, very well deserved. They're winning some of these stronger challenges. They've held the Dutch to two goals this half, which, to be perfectly honest, is not a bad showing.
No, I agree. They've the Finnish have settled down there.
Bit of a weird standoff there up front. And a very, very, very tense tackle by the Dutch number 6, who's a Dutch substitution. That's brought on Mehdi Adelkish. That's Adelkish number 6 on for Holland. Ball lost, a bit of weak control there. First touch of a man with a bad first touch there, I believe. Well, would you say that's the best Sunday League clearance of the Homeless World Cup that we've televised so far?
I think that ball might have ended up in history.
Something like that. Or broken a window in the Van Gogh Museum, at least. Diving header there from Holland, about the third header we've seen attempted this tournament. When somebody does score from one, I'm going to try and make them into some sort of legend. As we all know, it's the holy grail of any five-a-side performance. But that's the first half over. And Finland, having disgraced themselves, managed to hold Holland to 2 goals. Holland were a very skillful side, good in possession. But Finland have been tough, would you say?
Yeah, I think so. I think Holland settled down pretty much immediately when the game started. Finland took a few minutes to get into the game. And they now look like they've done quite well.
Yeah, I'd say that. I mean, we're going to see if we can get some more results that have come in from elsewhere in this tournament. I mean, we've had a few games taking place as we've been commentating, so we'll just look at this day two of the first stage coming live from the Homeless World Cup here in Amsterdam. And while I just take a quick look for some of those scores, can you maybe explain a bit more of the concepts of the World Cup to some of our viewers at home who might have tuned in late?
Yeah, absolutely. So the Homeless World Cup partners with local organisations all around the world. We have 48 men's teams competing this year in Amsterdam, as well as 16 women's teams. So we have the first group stage carrying on until Tuesday next week. The competition then moves to second group stage and ultimately to the trophy stage, with the finals being held.
Excellent. We're back underway now. So we've got everybody's competing for a trophy in every day. And we're back on. There's a lot of flapping around there by the Dutch winger. Adel Kish with the ball there. Back inside. We've got the Dutch number 8 on now. The Dutch number 8 is Damien Hall. Extremely acrobatic. Been trekked by like a bit of a celebrity by some of the local Dutch kids this morning and last night. Be nice to see Damien Hall pull off something quite as ridiculous as he tried to attempt in the first game by Holland. Adel Kish. Ball. Ball again. Kish. A lot of time for the Dutch here, isn't there? Just looking for that hole. Adel Kish ultimately skying that ball there, but there's a lot of working that possession really well in front of the Finnish goal.
Yeah, they're moving it across the pitch very, very well, moving the defence around. But as you said there, one of the advantages of the tournament and the structure is that every team gets to play competitive matches right to the last day. It really is well designed.
It leaves 6 trophies available, of course. The Homeless World Cup, designed by homeless people from Glasgow. And it's made up of lots of different symbols about how football can inspire the homeless. Another headed attempt there, headed layoff. And that should have gone in, and did. It's a great counter-attack by Holland. It was very, very good by Lambo, the Dutch keeper, to notice that massive overlap and get that ball into that area so that Holland could then split the Finnish keeper. Again. Dutch being very, very, very aggressive in front of goal. Adel Kish being strong there. Dutch number 8, Damien Hall. And the Dutch number 10 on the field, who is Farhan. Farhan's had some good games early on this one. Farhan on the ball now. Very confident by Farhan to tee that ball up. Hall, a little bit elaborate there, all the way across. It's another great goal by Holland. You feel like the Dutch substitutions are really invigorating this side.
I think so, yeah. Some of the Finnish guys look like they're tiring a little bit. It is quite a warm day today.
Yeah, I know, and it's from our promontory, which is not actually a promontory, it's the front of a van. I was thinking about revealing that later on in the tournament, but I want people to know that we're suffering in a very hot environment. Don't forget, guys, of course, don't leave children or dogs in hot cars without the window open a crack, but you can leave commentators in that environment. Lombo, Dutch line of a goalkeeper there.
Prefers not to wear gloves.
Hands like hams, that's what I hear. It's been very tough for Finland to get back into possession. We've had a Finnish swap there with Teong Ang coming back on, the number 20. But it's been difficult to really see a time when they've held any possession this second half.
Yeah, I think it gets cleared and comes back up quite quickly. So.
And the Dutch are really calm, controlled, and they're bossing these bouts of possession. That was an excellent little move from Adel Kish. Very, very clever, and could have easily wrong-footed the keeper. There's a heavy skill set in this Dutch side, something you'd really expect. I mean, growing up playing football, I was always told by my father about how good the Dutch were based upon their ability to play sort of six-a-side games and play futsal. But that was a big exponent of futsal when I was a child, you know, with a big heavy ball and these sorts of tight conditions. And you can see that really in this Dutch side. Great strike by Hall. Didn't really have to put his laces forward, just pick his spot, wrap his foot on for a little bit and get that in. So I think we're in the territory now where we can't really expect anything other than a Dutch win. So what we really need to think about is how Finland can get a few goals in this game, get a bit of confidence going into whoever they're going to play next. Because Holland are one of the stronger teams in the tournament, let's be honest.
Yeah, Holland traditionally strong, I think, in most years really at the Women's World Cup.
The token back on for Holland, for Finland, with his very recognisable bright blonde hair. Of course, Finland got an extremely large amount of blonde or white haired people, especially living in the north. As we famously see him about once every 2 months in National Geographic, I feel. The great ball across the face of the goal, just to be tapped in by Adam Kish. Playing using that space on the face of the goal is a very, very good idea for any team competing in this tournament, because the goalkeeper often can't reach the outer limits of his area. That's another great, great first by Adam Kish. 2 minutes left and it's 7-0 to the Netherlands.
I think that was an assist for the Dutch goalkeeper Lambo as well, who he's very good at moving the ball on his feet.
I think Lambo really notices when he's got a man open or he's got a bit of space. Finland for a goal there.
It's good to see Finland get off the mark. Excellent finish, really.
Yeah, I think when Finland find their level a bit more in the later stages of this tournament, you'll see some really good finish results, because there we go again, that's some excellent theatrics from the Dutch. Of course, extremely dangerous when you have two Finnish players around you, quite rightly we've blown up for a Finnish free kick there. But yeah, there's been a lot of acrobatics, so an incredibly entertaining side to watch. Just a minute and a half left in this game. Nice to see Finland pull back another couple of goals. That's Derichau back on for the Dutch side. Referee just pulling things in for a penalty. I can't assume there was some sort of encroachment in the area. Maybe three passbacks just create a penalty. That's not really been the case. That was a free kick.
Only two players are allowed to defend on the other side. One player should stay on the side.
This is the first time my sort of co-commentator slash nemesis on the field has really provided some excellent commentary there. A lot of playing around there by the Dutch on the wing, but that was because the Dutch striker did actually leave that area. You've got to leave one guy in the opponent's half at all times, or you will just get a free kick there given against you. Derichau, great bit of skill, but the shot wasn't quite there. 30 seconds left. It'd be nice to see something a bit elaborate from the Dutch field.
20 seconds to go.
Somewhere by Derichau, but again the finish quite weak. Great save though by the Finnish keeper to really, really get in the way of that second strike. Needed to be there and he was. Another weak effort by Derichau. And that's the game. So Finland 12, Netherlands 7. Undeniably deserved for the Netherlands, but it's no disgrace for Finland.